Hello friends, so today we are going to see in this script how to check port on multiple remote computer. So suppose we have to check the RDP port which is 3389 is open on the multiple remote computer, then how we will check that. So we just have to create a text file. We have to give the path here in the alt text. So let me show you the computer here. So I have a three computer here for the testing purpose. So I have mentioned this path and this is the three computer you can see here. Okay. So and we have to mention the port number here, so it will automatically make a connection to the 3389. We can also use the telnet, but telneting the computer one by one will take a time, so we have this PowerShell script. So we will run the script and we'll see what is the result here. Okay, so you will get the result like this: computer name, remote port, and the success, whether it is a true or false. False means the port is closed and true means the port is open. So it is showing that only the third computer have the RDP enabled and the other two don't have. So let me again open this RDP port here on the first computer. So we'll go here, enable the RDP port, and let me again run the script. Now we have again enabled the first computer RDP port, so it is giving the true result. On the second, it is still showing the false because the RDP is not enabled on this. Okay, so let me show you, it is not enabled here. Okay, it don't allow. So if I enable again here, it will give me the true result for all the computer. Okay, you can see the difference. Now suppose you want to export this file into the CSV, so how you will give it. So here we have to add the pipe. We have to give the export hyphen CSV command. Okay, then we have to give the path. Okay, here we will give the port result and we'll give the append. Okay, and we'll again run the script. Now this time it will not show result here in the PowerShell, but it will create a text file. We'll have the result. So here, suppose you want to test the multiple port, you can again with the same file you just have to add the new port here, and you can just do that. So it will give us the result in the same file. Okay, you can see here. Now it have created the 80 entry with this new port number. So you can just use this and then you can open this result into the CSV or the text file. You can here also give CSV. Okay. Okay, fine. Now the port result is in CSV format. Earlier I had given the text file. Okay, so this is the thing. So again, I'll close this. I'll go to the script 3389. Again, I'll run the script. Okay, it's run. Again, I'll open this file and you will have the 3389 with this. Okay, so if you have any doubt while using the script, you can put it into the comment box. I'll try to answer that. Thank you for watching the video.